There will never be enough pages, resources, sites, freebies, packs, anything you want that can satiate our thirst for resources to input in our architectural drawings. And if there was a list with the things that we needed the most for resources in our drawings, I'm sure the trees would be on the top of that list, or it would be competing with a human cutout. So in this quick video, we're gonna see what are the best sites that you probably may not know to download free PNG trees. So this video was created thanks to everyone that responded the questions that I asked on Instagram a few weeks ago. So if you want to be part of that and know a little bit more behind the scenes and get access to all those questions, then join our Instagram community and follow us at Let's Show It Better. I also want to thank our Patreons for supporting these videos. If you want to be a Patreon and get access to our full length videos, to our project files, and to some freebies each month, then click the link in the description. Okay, so let's dive in. The first site is maya.dk. So that is, I'm not sure how it's pronounced. It's M-E-Y-E.dk. And it is one of, I think it's the best site that I found for the trees. It's something that I wasn't aware of, and I discovered until the other day when someone mentioned it in the comments. And it's a crazy site. I'm kind of obsessed with it because, well, let me just tell you a little bit about it first. It's all of these things are for free, okay? So all of the trees that you see here are PNG trees that are already cut out, and they're all for free. And it's created by a Copenhagen landscape architect called Mikkel Aya. I think Aya is the way you pronounce it. And all the trees are available as high quality PNGs with no transparent background. So these trees are, so Mikkel Aya is a landscape architect, and he's also a photographer. So he traveled Copenhagen taking pictures of different trees, and he has them all mapped out. So where each tree was, he has it mapped out, and he also got these trees in its winter version, its fall version, in autumn and spring. So that is so crazy. So if you go to the main page, you can see that we have, you can filter them by seasons, and we can filter them by species. So I can maybe select all the autumn trees that he has, and it will just load them up right here. And like, maybe I want an autumn tree that is maybe of this kind, sorbus, and I will have these results right here. And if I want one of these trees, I just click on them, click on it again, and it will save the tree. So I can save it right here, and then I can drag it into my Photoshop file, let's say right here. And we can see that it's in a very, very high quality. If we zoom in, it's in a very high quality, and it's a very good tree. And we know that we can get that same tree in different seasons. So as you guys can see, autumn, evergreen, spring, summer, and winter. So this was honestly one of the best pages that I found for free PNG trees that I did not know of. We all know the classics, but this one was really, really hidden back there. And it has a ton of selection of trees. Honestly, like, you guys, you see me scrolling, and it's a lot of trees. So that is the first recommendation that I think you should visit if you want some PNG trees that are free and that are very high quality. The second page is pngtree.com. So if we take a look at it, pngtree.com, it's not totally free. It's a page that sells a lot of resources, templates, power, backgrounds, etc. But if we go over here where it says PNG and we filter it and we go by tree, there is a section where there's only free PNG trees. So if we click on one of them, as you guys can see, there are a ton of trees as well. So some of them have the shadows. Some of them are very classic trees that you would see among the internet that maybe some of you already have in your library. If you click on one of these, like, say, let's say for example, this tree, click here on free download. Let's say I want to register. Let's say I just register with my Google name. And well, the thing is that there's a lot of ads on this page, so that could be a bummer. But then I could download the PNG file. I have a credit limit each day. So it's kind of like textures.com where you have a credit limit. So I clicked right here and I can save it. And if we open it out in Photoshop, we can see that it is also a very high quality tree. Compared to the other one, it has some, it's a very nice size, and it has a big selection. The bummer is that you can only have 2 or 3 downloads per day, I think, but it has a very, very nice selection of trees, and it also has it in a PSD format if you want it in a PSD format. So that is pngtree.com. In case you guys want to visit it, it's for free, and it's also very, very good. The next recommended site is freepngimg.com. So a lot of these are, you know, kind of hard to remember, but this is freepngimg.com. And I'm supposing it has a lot of free things as well, like streetlights, maybe some icons, some illustrated things. But here it also has some really nice trees. Some of these are classic trees that I already have in my library, but it also, you guys can see it has a lot of trees. Let's say that we were to download this tree. It doesn't have the tree information, so you don't know what species it is specifically or where it's from. But you guys can see here how many people have downloaded the tree, what the color palette of the tree is, and some similar PNGs. So if we go over here, we can click on download, free download PNG, and it will not ask us to register or anything, it will just download it immediately. So if we drag it into our Photoshop file and open it, we can see that it also has a very nice quality in comparison to the other two, and it has a lot of selection of trees. So that is the third site that we recommend. So it's freepngimg.com. And the last website that we're gonna see is freeicons.png.com. So a lot of these resource websites have a ton of things that are not necessarily related to architecture or to visualization or whatever. It's for designers, for anything that you want. But if we click here on the home page, we click on trees and we click on search, there will be a ton of trees. It has some nice illustrative trees, but it also has some nice like real photorealistic trees that you can get. So for example, this is a pine that it's in a very nice resolution, and you can download it as a PNG. It won't ask you for anything as well, just to verify the security code right here. We click on download, we click on save, and we drag this file into our Photoshop. As you guys can see, it's of the three, of the four, it has a very nice resolution, and it also has a nice variety of them. So, and as a bonus tip, if you ever maybe don't have internet access, if you just have your Photoshop, in the latest versions of Photoshop, you can create your own trees. So I'm gonna show you exactly how to create our own tree using Photoshop. If we jump into our Photoshop file, I'm gonna turn all of these, layers off, and I'm going to create a new layer right here. And I'm going to go to filter, render, and go to render tree. So this option is available mostly in the latest versions of Photoshop. So I'm not sure if you're gonna have it, but I think the majority of us already have this version. I'm not sure from what version it was updated. So this window is going to appear where you have some presets, you're gonna have some basic options, how, you know, the camera tilt option of, you know, where specifically it's taking the picture, or it's just generating the render from. And you can also select different types of trees. So right now there are 32 types of trees that you can select: oak tree, redwood tree, ginkgo tree, maple tree, etc. So if we select, for example, willow tree, these are more illustrative type of trees, so they wouldn't work as much for maybe realistic renders. But for maybe collage style images, they would work fine because they're very good trees. And as you guys can see, we also have bamboo trees, we have palm trees. And if I wanted to maybe change the properties of this tree, I could change, for example, the light direction. So I wouldn't want it to have too much shadow, or maybe I would want it all of it in shadow. And I can also increment the leaves. So if I wanted just, you know, with very little leaves or maybe a lot of leaves, if you go to maybe an oak tree, I can decrease the leaves amount, and it can be more of a winter tree. I can also increase the leaf size. So if I, you know, turn it over to 200, it's gonna look like that. Or decrease the size, and it's also going to, you know, obviously erase the images. We can also change the height of the branches. Obviously, it can change the whole aesthetic of the tree and the branch thickness. You can also change the leaf type. So maybe I want, you know, my very own personal tree, and it has to be a very specific leaf type. So there are different types of leaves you could choose from here. If you wanted a more of an autumn type of tree, I could select the color here, maybe to an orange, and it would have that autumn touch to it. I can change the shading. I can enhance the contrast. I can also enhance the flat shading as well. So if we start to play with all of these parameters, you know, they could really work for a ton of different types of trees. Maybe these don't work as well for close-ups. If you want a tree in the foreground, it doesn't work as well, but for a lot of trees in the background, it works perfectly. And once we have this, we can save the preset as a certain type of tree and then press OK. And the tree will be generated right there on our Photoshop file. And if we zoom in, we can see that it has a lot of detail as well. And if we put them aside, you know, to our other trees that we downloaded from our websites, we can see that it has, well, you know, some very good resolution. And in case that all of these sites don't work for you, or if you don't like the render generator from Photoshop, you can always go to Google. Honestly, it's the option that I use the most. You can just type Google PNG trees and sort them by size, sort them by license, make sure you can use those trees in commercial works. And you can also make other types of sortings. Maybe I want some autumn trees, or maybe I want some really only green trees. So if you have any recommendations, please type them in the comments down below and let me know what you thought of these sites. I really love them, and I hope you guys like them as well, and it was useful for you guys. All right, so thank you guys for watching this video, and I will see you in a next video. Bye. So let me give you guys a sneak peek into my library that I have of resources. This library I can't share with you because this is not my library. This is libraries that I have gathered up from different people from different sites, so I can't resell them. But I imagine the majority of us have something like this. So if I go over here to vegetation, I have, well, this is in Spanish, but I have it filtered by size, type, and view. So if we go to view, I have some vegetation that is in elevation mode. Another other one that you can only see from the top view. And if we go back over here, we can see some JPEGs, PNGs, PSDs, TIFF files, and some types. And here I only have some palm trees. So if I go, for example, to size and PNG, I also have it sub filtered. So I have big trees, medium trees, small trees, and various sizes and kind of fragments. So these are all trees that I downloaded from different types of websites. As you guys can see, I have a ton of them. I have a ton of trees right here. So that is all I have to say about that. Thank you, Patreons. I will see you in a next video. Bye.